Hello wildlife lovers and welcome back to episode 4 of the Dikala Wildlife series from Discover Wild Paws. In the previous 3 episodes, we encountered a tiger twice. Make sure you watch all the episodes of this series now. Before we begin this episode, we request you to subscribe to our channel Discover Wild Paws. Let's begin this virtual safari now. As the barricades were removed by the forest department, we started crossing the famous bridge of Ram Ganga in Dikala. Earlier this morning, a tigress, one of Paro's cub, was seen crossing the river to come this side. So we waited on the bridge to check if she is resting anywhere in the water. The bridge is not open throughout the year. It is built every year sometime by the end of November and then stays till April. Then before the monsoons, it is demolished and reconstructed again the following year. As we crossed the river and came the other side, we saw 3 scared sambar deer. They looked confused as to where to go. The rule of the jungle says we should never ignore the signs these scared prey animals give us. We observed them for a while and then they disappeared into the grasslands. And then, very close to where we saw the sambar deer, we saw a bunch of otters swimming. Anyway, we moved further into the jungle to find Paro and cubs. As the morning sunlight came filtering through the tree leaves, the jungle looked as if it is wearing jewelry. In winters, the initial hour of the safaris is difficult as it is extremely cold and the visibility is low. But as the sun starts coming up, it gets better and better. The opposite is true for a summer safari. The building you see was under construction and we stopped here to take a washroom break. From this side of the river, we could see the Dikala FRH, where we were staying. The river was absolutely still and there was utter silence in the jungle. After the break, we continued our search. The surprising thing was that the tigress crossed the river early morning and then as we came this side, there were no signs at all. This was the first time we had crossed Dikala Bridge in our lives. The jungle on this side looked different. It was more dense and the experience felt new. The frustration was building up, but we didn't lose hope. We decided to go to the extreme end of the forest to find any clue marks. But what we found was a cormorant bird. Finally, to make best use of our time here, we thought we will wait near the banks for 5-10 minutes more. And if there are no signs, we would go back to the other side and look for the grassland wali tigress. Now these are some tough decisions you have to take while on a safari. If you decide to switch places, you might miss the tiger, but you have to draw a line to the waiting time, or else you will miss the overall experience. There were no more calls, and on these big stones, it is hard to locate any tiger pug marks. So we made our move back to the bridge. and on our way back, we encountered a herd of elephants. In the jungle, you are more likely to be attacked by an elephant than by a tiger. So when you see them, show respect and keep your distance. Elephants are like the eldest member of the jungle family. They have created these jungles and they have the power to destroy it too. As we move further towards grasslands, something exciting happened. You can see the jeeps waiting, but what you cannot see is a big elephant on the left, looking to cross the road. As it came out, all the jeeps moved backward and then let it cross the road. And after this elephant encounter began the waiting game of the jungle. As the clock was ticking and we had to get back to the campus, we all had no choice but to wait 100 meters away from the campus and hope that some magic happens. And then came a visitor, a hungry jackal looking for food. Jackals are scavengers and are responsible for cleaning the jungle. And while we were filming the jackal, came a loud spotted deer alarm call. But this time, the call was not for the tiger. It was neither for a leopard. It was for a yellow-throated marten. One of the most exclusive sightings of Corbett so far. So this safari ended with an early morning tiger sighting followed by finding the elusive marten. In a coordinated attack, yellow-throated marten can bring down a spotted deer too, and hence there was a call. In the next episode, we will begin our afternoon safari where something thrilling happened. Stay tuned to watch and subscribe to our channel Discover Wild Paws to never miss a video from us.